Welcome to A Pastor's Perspective. I'm Ken Gray, and I serve here at Calvary Life Family Worship Center in Cheshire, Connecticut. Today, our devotion is in 1 Samuel chapter 2. We've been looking at the life of Elkanah and Hannah and their first son, Samuel, whom they dedicated to the Lord at the time of his weaning, which means he was probably only around 3 or 4 years old. Elkanah, Hannah, and Samuel are contrasted with Eli and his two sons, Hophni and Phinehas. We'll see here, having looked at Eli's sons, who were really wicked men taking advantage of their position and authority to nurture their own selves and not tend to or serve God's people. Now we come to Samuel, and it goes back and forth between Samuel and Eli and his sons and Elkanah and their family. Now Samuel was ministering before the Lord as a boy wearing a linen ephod. Now he's here starting out at a young age with appropriate clothing that God had indicated should be worn. So he is clearly being contrasted with Eli's sons, Hophni and Phinehas. He starts out his life of ministry good. And his mother would make him a little robe and bring it to him from year to year when she would come up with her husband to offer the yearly sacrifice. Though Hannah had dedicated her son Samuel to the Lord and to the service of the Lord, she did not stop caring for him or even providing for him, but she made him a garment every year and brought it to him when they would come to worship. And again, she was not embittered at the loss of her son. In fact, she seems to be even more joyful in her worship. And at the time of this coming to the Lord, when she would come to worship and provide for her son, it says in verse 20, "Then Eli would bless Elkanah and his wife and say, 'May the Lord give you children from this woman in place of the one she dedicated to the Lord.' And then they would go home. And the Lord visited Hannah, and she conceived and gave birth to 3 sons and 2 daughters. And the boy Samuel grew before the Lord." It's so interesting here because in the context of their faithfulness, that is Elkanah and Hannah, they receive a blessing from the corrupt priest. And he blesses them and asks God to provide them additional children. And God did do this, and he honored that blessing, and he visited them, allowing them to have 5 more children. But more importantly, it says, "And the boy Samuel grew before the Lord." You see, Hannah and Elkanah's faithfulness to God in worship and to their vow of dedication resulted in God's blessing. Faithfulness and dedication always precedes the blessing of the Lord. And the most important benefit that we can receive is that our children would do well in the Lord, and Samuel grows up before the Lord. It's not that he was not in the presence of evil, because Eli and his sons were very wicked men, but the influence, the primary influence, was the presence of the Lord. And I believe that's a direct result of his parents' dedication. Not long after I started Bible school, my mother reminded me, I'll probably get a little emotional about this, but please forgive me, reminded me that she and my dad dedicated me to the Lord at a very young age. And this dedication, though, in their lives was not only one that was made at my birth, I saw it in their lives throughout my growing up. So when I became involved in ministry and I attended Bible school and then made a commitment to go to the mission field for over a year, that is on the other side of the world at a very difficult time in my life because my wife had cancer. When I made that commitment, my wife and I together, we made that commitment to go there. I can't tell you how difficult it was to give my parents a hug in the airport as we got on that airplane, knowing that we wouldn't see them very likely for a long time. My best friend was there. We wept on each other's shoulders as we departed. Even though I was only about 25 years old, we cared much for each other. We were like brothers. And this kind of dedication that my parents made in my life has resulted in many blessings, a long-term relationship with the Lord, and the blessing of my own children as well. I want to encourage you today that though dedication is pricey and very costly. Faithfulness to God in worship is very costly. That the long-term benefits, or I should say, the eternal benefits, far outweigh those momentary costs and price that are associated with it. Let me pray with you that as a parent, maybe, if you're a parent, or even as a young person, to give yourself to dedication and faithfulness and worship, because the eternal benefits are incredible. Let me pray. Father, I thank you for amazing parents that you blessed me with. How they not only dedicated me as a child to your care, to your protection, but they dedicated themselves to raising me in the church and in the influence of the Holy Spirit and the Word of God. And Father, they embodied an incredible example to me and became a blessing. And I pray for those that are out there in a world that is filled with evil and is filled with all kinds of corrupt influences, that we would be a people that would know there is a tremendous value in dedication and also in faithfulness in worship. We thank you for this in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, God bless you, and thank you for listening to A Pastor's Perspective. Every Wednesday evening at 7 p.m., we have Bible study here at Calvary Life Family Worship Center at 174 East Johnson Avenue in Cheshire, Connecticut. Come and join us. We have a wonderful time. God bless you.